Hello team, welcome back to our review. This week we're going to be seeing the future time. We're going to be starting with some of the more famous ones, going to, will, present continuous. We're going to see a couple of extra ones that you might not be familiar with. But remember, this week's class is about focusing on the nuances of comprehension of the person listening. So we're going to start off with going to. It's probably the most common. Going to has to do with an intention or a plan. What does that mean? With an intention, it's something that I would like to do. I like to joke that it's what people say on December 31st. They have an intention for the next year. On the other side, they have plans. What do I mean by a plan? So before our conversation, it's something that I have already thought about. It's a plan, which will make the opposite of will, which works for facts instead of intentions. And when I say facts, I don't mean like Newton's laws. What I mean by facts are that me, the speaker, I am saying this as a fact. I believe in it. And I like to use the example of soccer fans. They don't say, oh, I think my team's going to win. No, my team will win on Saturday. So they're treating it like a fact. And the other one would be for spontaneous decisions. If I spill some water, I'll go get a mop. It's something that I hadn't planned before the conversation. So we have going to, plans and intentions, will, facts, spontaneous decisions. We're going to watch a movie Friday. If something better pops up, maybe we'll do that. The lights went out. I'll go get the flashlight. So I wasn't planning for the electricity to go out. Continuing on, we have the present continuous. This is something that I have noticed that native speakers usually use a little bit more, and it's for fixed arrangements. We will use it together with an anchor word in the future, in this case Friday, this week, and it's something to place it into the future. But we use this for a fixed arrangement, something that is already kind of has already started. So if I say I'm going to watch a movie on Friday, you know, it's an idea. It's something that I would like to do. If I say we are watching a movie on Friday, you've probably already looked up what time it's showing. You know where it is. Maybe you've even bought the popcorn. It's already kind of started. We're going to see three more that are a little bit less common. We have the present simple, which we use for timetables. What do I mean by timetables? Anything that we can put into Google Calendar. We usually use it for trips, for classes, for meetings. It's usually in the third person and it'll be pretty specific. The meeting is at 12. George and Mary arrive on Wednesday. Remember, it has to be able to fit into a calendar. Next up, we have the future perfect. I really like this name. It sounds like a sci-fi movie. But we use this for future limits. Think of a deadline. It's almost the opposite of the present perfect, where you start in the past and extend until the present. Here, we extend from now until a point in the future. We're going to make this with will plus have. The package will have arrived by then. Well, let's say that by then is in 2 weeks. You would have known by the conversation. But it could arrive tomorrow, the next day, the next day. But we have a limit, a deadline. The project won't have been finished by Tuesday. Again, with the Tuesday deadline. Last up, we have the future continuous. I am calling it an interrupted action, but that is because I couldn't think of a better term. If you have any ideas, send them to me. But we will use will or going to together with be with the ing to say that something will be happening while something else is happening or at a certain period of time. We will be watching the game tonight. So tonight we will be watching the game. And same thing, what will you be doing on Saturday? Saturday is happening, what will you be doing then? All right, team, any questions, send them my way. I'm sorry it was a little bit longer this video, but thank you and I'll see you in class.